Nityanandam, my name is Radhakrishnan. I am from Kunur, a similar hill station to Kodaikanal. I work in Dubai. I'm working with a landscape architect, a landscape consultant. I'm working as an associate irrigation engineer. I've been in Dubai since 2004, 8 years I'm there. My jump into the spiritual path, especially with Swamiji, it happened in 2009. I'm supported by my brother who also lives in Kunur. He's a doctor. As of now, he's a healer initiated by Swamiji. He came into the spiritual path in 2007 and he pulled me sometime in 2009. He gave me an offering of Swamiji's lecture wherein I was inspired by the truths which Swamiji had, especially the discourse of intuition in Microsoft. In fact, I am a great intellect nut, which was very hard to be broken. And when I saw Swamiji's intuition management, I was inspired by the truth and I just jumped into spirituality. It so happened that me and my better half, Sridevi, both of us came to the spiritual path. It so happened that we met Swamiji in January 2010 when we had an inspiration to come all the way to Bidadi to meet Swamiji, but it didn't happen that way. Swamiji just came to Dubai and we had to take a 20-minute drive from our house to meet Swamiji. It was a blessing in disguise, the first time we met Swamiji. But when the first time we met Swamiji, it was we were also inspired by the meditation technique of Nitya Dhyan through my brother, which I have been doing it for the next 5 months. And when I met Swamiji, and there was a turning point after I had to be in his physical presence. Then as days went by, then subsequently over the year, the first scandal broke down. And then after that, we were much inspired by his truth and teachings. And we all came down for attending the first NSP after the scandal. It was very powerful. We had a great experience of especially the death meditation and the overnight meditation of consciously sleeping. Subsequently, it happened. Then I'm right now here. My better half had already completed inner awakening in December 2010, and it's after 2 years I am already here. Meanwhile, I also had the blessings of Swamiji to run a satsang center, so we somehow managed to convert our house into a satsang center in Dubai, and we were able to manage to have weekly satsangs in Dubai, getting people over the weekend and sharing all our spiritual practices and to get updates from Swamiji on every Fridays. So almost every week we have been in touch with Swamiji. In Dubai, we started living, having food only twice a day, doing Paduka Puja with the Padukas which he had brought us. It was a blessing for us. We started doing Puja 5 times in a day and doing all meditation, Nitya Dhyan, Enkriya and all possible meditations which Swamiji had given to match our present lifestyle. And as Swamiji had said, converting your laundry list, when spirituality entered our life, it was somewhere in middle. But later on, it came to happen that spirituality is now the first thing in our laundry list. So the early morning we get up, it is only with spirituality we start the day, and then the laundry list is only after these spiritual practices are done. It's amazing to be here in Inner Awakening, especially this place, Kodaikanal. Since I'm also from Kunur, a similar hill station, I also feel at home here. Earlier, when we came here, we had a kind of hangover that since we are not in Bidadi, that we might miss the Vaidya Sarovar and the Bidadi banyan tree. But with Swamiji's presence here, all got vanished away. And in the presence of Swamiji, nothing matters. Forms don't matter at the moment. Inner Awakening has been a great blessing for us. We went through all the intellectual, the meditative part, the yoga part. Especially, I somehow perceive that Inner Awakening this time has been more physical, because Swamiji had once said that he doesn't believe in our mind. So I think he has gone into the transformation of transforming body. Then he will take care of the mental part. It was a kind of very good experience for me, because when I came to Inner Awakening, I had an initial experience since 2009. I've been putting a lot of spiritual practice in terms of yoga and meditation. So I really feel that that has really helped me in coming here and performing these activities. But last but not the least, it is not only the practices which we put forward, it is our opening for the change. And we were all blessed by Swamiji for 21 darshans in the whole span, I think, which has never happened in any Inner Awakening. We were blessed. We had a lot of sessions with Swamiji during breakfast break, which is very rare happening. It is, It's very rare to be just sitting with an incarnation to have breakfast with the idlis and vadas. It's really great to have. The contribution from my side in terms of the blessings which Swamiji has made to happen it through me. In 2010, when I had attended the Life Bliss Program Level 2 NSP in India, I had taken a blessing from him that I had a thought of coming out with the electronic spiritual digital diary, which would contain all spiritual practices under the umbrella of Swamiji Nityananda. So that each beginner or a satsang center coordinator or any experienced or a intent seeker would benefit from this. So Swamiji had said, okay, I will help you, I will support you, go and do this. So it's after 2 years which I came here and I presented the CDs to the first day on Darshan, and Swamiji had taken some time to see this. But to my surprise, today morning there was a blast in the morning satsang that Swamiji just came out and said, he just called out my name, my spouse's name, and said that a wonderful happening just happened today and he wants to share it to the world. I was taken aback when Swamiji said that he has imbibed him the whole thing himself, and he said he wants to share to the world. Then I was really taken back and I was really extremely surprised by his words. He had almost taken 10-15 minutes to go through the content. And the kind of promotion which I wanted to do in that, I think Swamiji had made it complete and more than what was actually required. He did more than what I wanted. There was nothing else for me to just keep quiet. And the surprise in which Swamiji was taken, because I had to put all Swamiji's teachings and all compilations in one content and then show it to Swamiji. Swamiji himself was surprised. So I think as a momentary gift, I think Swamiji had presented me this mala, which I am very grateful to hold it, and Swamiji sits here. The greatness of this mala is, I think this has been on Swamiji's shoulder for quite a long time, and he instantly, immediately took it out and he called me and he said, come, this is what I can do for you now. Then I thought, enlightenment is only this and nothing else. So he has taken me to greater heights, and not only this, I had released the version 12.1, which is the first version, and with a lot of inspiration from Swamiji and confidence, I would go through taking up much more data and compiling them together, and to see the whole world gets benefited by this. We have just a day left in Inner Awakening. It's probably by end of day tomorrow. And we are also fortunate, this batch of Inner Awakening people, participants are fortunate enough that we also have a schedule of touring Madurai Adinam, the Madurai Meenakshiamman temple, and the Thiruvannamalai temple. And we were all blessed by Swamiji finally coming out and telling that he is also accompanying us. So it's going to a great divine place like Madurai and Thiruvannamalai, along with an incarnation like Swamiji. I think there's nothing else we will be looking forward for achievement. In my case personally, I would feel, if at all, that's very something which is very great to be achieved, I have achieved this today. That's it. Thank you very much, Nityanandam. I would advise all the seekers and the people who are being inspired by Swami's teachings. And if anybody gets a click from the message which I am trying to tell you, leave alone all your intellectual nuts. There is a lot of things which is beyond logic, and Swamiji works completely with things which are not fitting within our logic, because the logic is part of our mind. So many things happen beyond our mind, and today morning Swamiji had given us a glimpse of the space in which he is living, and I had personally experienced this, and this cannot be told by words, it can be only done by experience. So I would recommend all people who are seeing, as Swamiji had said, out of two eyes, one eye is Inner Awakening and the other eye is Kailash. Never miss any of the eyes. So do Inner Awakening and do Kailash, and you will see the space in which Swamiji is living, and you will be one with the whole. Thank you very much. Nityanandam.